about it, and I get maybe bored with it, but you've got to be really, or else you're not going to be here much longer, you know. Now is never very important to most people. But it's really all you've got. It's really all we live in. You can't do anything better than working with John Lennon. But, you know, that's certainly true, I think. You know, I mean, they thought John was such a monster that it certainly would be very difficult to work with anyone better. And I love being in a band. It's a luxury to be in a band. It's a like real big luxury. I'd rather have a band than a Rolls Royce.
Flowers in the Dirt. It's been some 2 years in the making. Are you finally happy with the result?
Yeah. Yeah, because I think mainly because we're going out on tour, that we kind of probably took a little bit more care over this one. I just don't want to get stuck out in America somewhere on tour, plugging an album that you don't like, you know. So realizing we had so much work to do with it, with the thought of touring, we concentrated on kind of what the songs were, and probably a bit more than we would usually on sort of trying to get them right, you know.
Right, okay, let's just try. Now I'm alone again, yeah. Now, 2, 3, 4.
Now that I'm alone again, I can't stop breaking down again. The simplest things set me off again. Take me to that place where I can find my brave face, where I can find my brave face, where I can find my brave face.
That's it.
On the songs that you do play bass on, like My Brave Face, that you've still kept that very melodious bass style. I mean, that's got a beautiful bass riff in it, hasn't it?
Yeah, well, I suppose that comes out of Elvis Costello, who I wrote that one with. When we came to record it the first time, he said, what about your Hofner bass, you know, your violin bass, the Beatle bass? And I was saying, well, I can try it, but it's not very good at keeping in tune, which it isn't, because they're not very expensive instruments, you know. I got it a long time ago. And can go a little bit out of tune. So I'd given up recording with it, really, in favour of more some modern instruments that, like, technically they'll hold the tuning and things like that. But he said, oh, I love the sound of it, you know. Go on, let's try it. So I said, yeah, sure. So I got it out, tried it and that, and it recorded great. That was the thing about it. The tone, it's got a lovely tone for a little bass. So that's how that riff arrived, you know, because it was sounding great and stuff. It makes you want to play a nice little distinctive riff. So I got into that by request.
1, 2, 3, 4. My brave bass. I've been doing well on a custom design to this luxury line. I've been hitting down, only you didn't get back.
Yeah, it was funny though, the resemblance to John was once or twice got a bit embarrassing. You know, there are a couple of tracks on the album where I'd sing a sort of sweet line and then I'd find Elvis doing a sort of sarcastic line, very much like John and me used to do. It's getting better all the time, couldn't get much worse. Like you say, you know, I remember the sort of old rock and roll stuff. Guys like Elvis or younger guys will remember the sort of the Beatles stuff. And if they love it, it's great for me. You know, you're kidding, aren't you? You know, it's great to see someone love it instead of slagging it off and saying, oh, it's the pastiche of the Beatles. You know, it's like, yeah, man, it sounds like the Beatles. Great, you know, what could be more fun? And I always think, you know, well, if anyone's allowed to do it, it's got to be me and the lads.
There's little touches there, like a certain guitar sound on My Brave Face, or, yeah, as you say,
well, the bit on My Brave Face. Take me to that place. That's really like me and John.
Take me to that place.
And I did say to Elvis, we've got to really be careful about that, you know, but I mean, you can't be too careful, can you?
I've been doing a night on a custom design to the work of a spy. I've been breaking up daddy dishes and been throwing them away. Ever since you left, I've been trying to compose. I'll be there with you. Come on, no, and for you. As I peel away another untouched TV dinner from the table.
When I was looking around for who I'd work with on this album, what producers, you know, were either available or would be willing to work together with, Trevor's name came up. And I'd heard, you know, some of these kind of rumours, like that go around the business and stuff, like, oh, he takes 3 months to make a single, you know. It's probably just because one of the Frankie ones. I think he did take that long. And I didn't fancy getting involved in a single that took 3 months. Just not my kind of style, you know. So I said to Trevor and Steve Lipson, who he works with, I said, do you fancy trying to do something over 2 days? Because, you know, I thought it'd kind of throw the cat amongst the pigeons for them as well as for me. The first 2 days, the result was the track on the album called Rough Ride. I had really nothing little thing. Hang on, I will. I just happened to have a guitar here. Yeah. I will demonstrate. It was like, it really was nothing. It was just like, rough ride. Oh, rough ride. Really just, oh, rough ride. Right. That was a very good demonstration, wasn't it? I could do that again, you know, if you know. Second thoughts.
Oh. need you loving. I needed a friend. I needed something that would be there in the end. All the rough ride to heaven. I wanna get inside. What can I do? Oh, rough ride to heaven. I wanna get inside. I wanna be with you. Oh, yeah. I knew you helped me.
Help me.
I knew you could.
Oh.
I knew I didn't wanna be misunderstood on a rough ride. I wanna be inside. What will I do?
It was one of the ones I did with Trevor and Horn and Lipson, Trevor and Steen. And again, it was a two-day thing. You know, we said, let's do it quite quickly. And Chris was playing drums on it. We were going to do the drums live. It wasn't going to be computer. So we wanted live drums. So I was in here with him. And I was playing bass. And I decided to kind of sing it along. And it had a tune which was fairly sort of lowish. Figure of eight. Quite sort of simple. But because I was leading the drummer and trying to get him to really sort of put it in loud, I decided to kind of take it up a bit. Wow, figure of eight. And start just sort of busking it up higher, you know. And we did that. We did it live like that. And the vocal and the drums are the two off that live take. And we then fixed some other stuff because the bass wasn't that good. So I was doing all this silly singing.
You got me dancing in a figure of eight. Don't know where I'm coming, I'm going, I'm early on.
I've been riding a J-Flow in a place.
Beatles records or the Beatles CDs now, which happened. That's the big thing that's happened now. You know, everyone kind of re-listening to them because of CDs. And I'll listen to them and I think, oh, it's a nice song, that. And that's the attraction, really, for me. Is, I mean, at rehearsal just the other day, we suddenly came up with Things We Said Today, which is an old Beatles song of mine. It's a really nice song to play. It's a very simple song, kind of says something nice. And when you've written them, you know, it's like meeting old friends again.
You say you'll be my girl till the end of time. Is there such a guy? Seems so hard to find. Someday when we're dreaming, deep in love, not a lot to say. I fall in love with her. Says she wouldn't dance with another. Oh, when I saw her standing there, well, my heart went boom when I crossed that room and I held her hand in my
You know, as I said at the time, I thought it was a quote from someone, I said, you can't reheat a souffle. And, you know, that's sort of right, really. We, with the Beatles, it just was what it was. And it was some kind of phenomenon. And there was no getting it back together again, you know. It just wouldn't have been the same.
The long and winding road that leads to your door. I've seen that road before. It always leads me here. Lead me to your door. Crying for the day. Don't keep me waiting here. Let me know. Times I cry. Anyway, you'll never know the many ways I try, but still they lead me back to the long and winding road. You let standing here a long, long time ago. Don't keep me waiting here. Lead me to your door. Yeah.
One song on the album which sounds personal but perhaps isn't because of the dedication is How Many People. Do you want to tell me a bit about that?
Yeah, that got the dedication after I'd written the song. It's kind of reggae-ish type thing that I wrote. But the chorus, the end line sort of says, how many people have died? And then the chorus says, one too many for me. You know, that's kind of the idea of the song. And when I heard about Chico Mendes' fight in the rainforest, and that he'd got shot was the crux of the matter, you know. I just thought it really fitted, you know, if ever there was one too many there, you know, the poor guy is trying to save the planet and he gets blasted, you know. It's like so stupid, it's how it happens. So I just thought, well, you know, the least I can do is like sort of mention it somewhere, so we just dedicated it on the album to him. Because, you know, I think anyone with any sense these days got to be like ecologically minded. They may not want to talk about it, or they get maybe bored with it, but you've got to be, really, or else you're not going to be here much longer, you know. And someone like him, you know, I always feel sorry for someone like him who sort of gets singled out. He's a married man, and it's so much easier for him to just go and get on with his life and say, oh, sod this for a game of cards, you know, sod the rainforest, and sort of go home and get drunk or something, you know. But they don't, they stay out there, and eventually someone gets to him, you know. So I just thought that was a real bummer, that whole thing. So we've dedicated a track to him, and it seems to fit, you know.
Well, how many people stand in a line? How many people never get a chance to shine? If you can tell me, I'll gladly listen. How many people have died? One too many right now for me. I wanna be happy. I wanna be free. Ground.
I think something like this one, that is a regret. You know, it's like, how many people think that, you know, that, oh God, if I only said that, or if I only sent her some flowers, then she, you know, or whatever. And I think one of the things for me is you do regret those moments. We have an argument, for instance, you know. You think, oh God, if I'd only been smart, I could have just sort of said, well, yeah, you know, you're right, for instance, would be a real cool thing to say, which I'm not always the one to say, you know. And it's about that kind of thing, you know, that that sort of this moment, this now, if you could just appreciate it all the time, and you'd do better. But you're nearly always off on some other moment, either the past or dreaming about the future. And now is never very important to most people. But it's really all you've got. It's really all we live in.
Did I ever take you in my arms, look you in the eye, tell you that I do? Did I ever open up my heart and let you look inside? If I never did, I was only waiting for a better moment that didn't come. There never could be a better moment than this one. This one,
this one is gliding
above the ocean.
A god is riding upon his back. How calm the water and bright the rainbow. Say that you were mine. Thank you for the smile. Did I ever knock upon your door, try to get inside? If I never did it, I was only waiting for a better moment that didn't come. There never could be a better moment.
This one
is gliding above the ocean.
A god is riding upon his back.
How calm the water and bright the rainbow.
Is this one to glide? What opportunities did we allow to go by? Feeling like the time it was. What kind of magic might have worked if we stayed gone? Couldn't I have given you a better life? Did you ever take me in your arms, look me in the eye, tell me that you do? Did I ever open up my heart, let you look inside? If I never did it, I was only waiting for a better moment that didn't come. There never could be a better moment than this one. This one.
put it there is for a particular kind of audience. I mean, it's just basically a song that my based on something my dad used to say when we were kids. And it's got a Liverpool silly things they say all the time. And he just say, put it there if it weighs a ton. It's one of his things, you know. And he also used to say, you'd say to him, well, why do we have to do that? Me and my brother, you know, why do we have to do that? He said, because there's no hair on a seagull's chest. Okay, fine, you know, it's all these nutty things he'd say. But that one, put it there if it weighs a ton, it's the kind of thing you then say to your own son. I mean, it's fairly simple, you know, while you and I are here, put it there. But, I mean, you can either say, well, that's just really simplistic, but, I mean, to me, that's really deep. But it is, you know, I mean, that's something that's a bit of a choker for me, that line.
As long as you and I are here, put it there. As long as you and I are here, put it there.
Because it's just a little acoustic thing. It's difficult what you set against it, you know. You almost want to leave it with just the acoustic and the voice. So we did little things like, that's sort of in there, hands have got to be very dry. And tapping on the knees like Buddy Holly did on the Everyday. It's an old trick, this little. So you get kind of very little percussive things. So we did that, we had a bit of a laugh on that one. Trying to persuade me to strip off, as I recall.
Yeah. Put it there. Ambo, you know, you're keeping the old body.
That's what a father said to his young son. I
don't
care. Get away. That's Hambone. That's what those guys do. They
play
every part of the
song.
You know,
in the wind.
Put it
there.
As long as you and I here. Put it there.
Sick, man.
That's the one, man. You can't ask for any more than that, man. I'm not going any further.
I like to shake it. I wanna show you I'm your friend. You'll understand if I can make it clear. It's all that matters in the end. Put it there, it weighs a ton. That's what a father said to his young son. As long as you and I are here, put it there. As long as you and I are here, put it there. If there's a fight, I'd like to fix it. I hate to see things go so wrong. The darkest night and all its mixed emotion is getting lighter. Sing along. Put it there, it weighs a ton. That's what a father said to his young son. I don't care if it weighs a ton. As long as you and I are here, put it there. As long as you and I are here, put it there.
You did the Russian album in 2 days.
I was telling you that we were doing some jamming basically looking at musicians, trying to have a bit of a sort of live moment, you know, rather than like recording all the time. And whenever we did those jams, I found that the main things we were jamming on were like old rock and roll songs from when I was about 18. And we only did one that I'd written, you know, whereas I suppose you would have thought we'd do all my songs. But they're much easier to jam because there's less chords and people know them. So we ended up doing that, and I thought, let's bring it into the studio and see if we could capture some of those, because they felt good when we jammed. Then we do Ain't That a Shame, which is the old Fats Domino song. Which is one of my big faves from then. I love his record of that. And do a couple of Elvis ones, Just Because. Well, Just Because. Which is just, you know. I was a big fan of Elvis's before he joined the army in 1956. There's a video of him actually in Elvis in 1956, I think it's called. And it's just what I loved about him on that video. But then at the end of the year, he gets into films. And he goes to Hollywood, and I think I detect a little twinkle gone out of his eye, because he was always hamming it up, Elvis. Hey, what? It was always like a joke. There was always like a little funny thing, and he does, oh, hold me close, hold me tight, and he's doing this thing, and for every single little word, there's like a, he's looking at a fan or he's joking, and he just does it so great. I love him.
Well, just because you think you're so pretty. And just because your mom thinks you're the hottest thing in town. Just because you think you got something. And nobody yet has got. Oh, you talk to me, you spend all my money. And you laugh, you call me, oh, Santa Claus. I'm telling you, well, I'm doing you. Because, well, just because. Because, well, just because, honey, because, well, just because. Your daddy's rich, and you know your mama's good looking. Hush, little baby. Hush now, baby. Well, don't cry. You know it's summertime.
In the studio.
Oh yeah, I mean you've got to have silly moments, you know, because it can get a bit intense sometimes. You're trying to get a take or something.
Now then, my brain, face. Now's about that, then how's about that. Now then. Oh, I'm running the marathon.
So, yeah, we've had some fairly silly times. Well, they're quite a silly band as well, as you've probably noticed being here the last couple of days. So it's good, you know, it just releases the tension, you know. I don't like things too serious myself, you know. We got into it for a laugh, you know, music. So there's no point in kind of getting it all serious now, really.
The album's called Flowers in the Dirt. Who are you hoping is going to buy the record? I mean, obviously, everyone, as many people as possible, but are you hoping to attract any kind of new audience?
No, I don't think like that, you know. That's marketing men think like that. Mm. Audiences, new formats, groups, target groups and stuff. It all goes funny when I start to think of it like that, you know. So I hope to attract anyone. Like a bloody dung heap, if you ask me.
What is this thing in life that persuades me to spend time away from you? If you can answer this, you can have the moon. This is the place to be, anywhere you can see, there's a lovely view. Butterflies are buzzing round my head when I'm alone. I think of you and the life we'd lead if we could only be free from these distractions. At the door, while the telephone rings on the kitchen wall. butterflies are buzzing round my head. I'm alone, I think of you and the things we do. If we could only be through with these distractions.
Conceive of a time where it might stop and where music might play less of a role in your life, and would you regret it if it did stop?
Well, I'm not even interested in that question.
Fair enough.
So there, Tracy. I'll do music as long as I do music. I'll live as long as I live. You know, and both of them are two imponderables that I'm not... They're so imponderable, I don't even bother wasting time trying to think of the answer, you know?
You can't ask for any more than that, man.
We had enough of playing. We played it all day long. We wanna go to the pub now. The beers are getting strong. We said party, party. All night long. We wanna party, party. All night long. Come on, Wixie boy. Take it down. Well, we're gonna say goodnight now. We've had it up to here. We've been sweating and singing all day long, and I'm feeling better. Party, party. Yeah. All night long. It's a good to me, won't you? Party, party.
Thank you. When the night is cloudy, there is still a light that shines on me. Shine until tomorrow, let it be. I wake up to the sound of music, Mother Mary.